Hypersensitivity. Hypersensitivity diseases occur when there is an excessive immune response to foreign antigens. This may result in tissue damage. The immune response that is caused by the failure of self-tolerance leads to autoimmune diseases. In all hypersensitivity reactions, the first exposure to antigen sensitizes lymphocytes and the subsequent exposure causes damage. The response is specific to particular antigens. Types of hypersensitivity. Hypersensitivity diseases are classified on the basis of the effector mechanism responsible for tissue injury. There are four types. Type 1, or immediate hypersensitivity. This type of hypersensitivity is mediated by IgE antibodies and mast cells. It manifests within minutes if re-exposed to the antigen. The IgE-mediated response is protective against parasites. Allergic individuals may develop the response if exposed to inappropriate stimuli. The effector of type 1 hypersensitivity includes mast cells, basophils, and eosinophils. During the first exposure to antigen, the antigen is captured by antigen-presenting cells, or APC, and is presented to the Th2 cells. The Th2 cells will release interleukin, such as IL-4 and IL-13, that stimulates B cells. The B cells undergo class switching to produce immunoglobulin E. The IgE will attach to the Fc receptor on the mast cells and basophil. During the second exposure to antigen, the allergen will cross-link several IgE molecules on the mast cells. The cells then will degranulate and release powerful chemicals that induce hypersensitivity. Type 1 hypersensitivity examples are 1. Allergic rhinitis. 2. Systemic anaphylaxis. 3. Asthma. 4. Wheal and flare. Type 2, or antibody-mediated hypersensitivity. In type 2, antibodies that are produced against a foreign antigen may become cross-reactive with the self-component of tissue. Hence, they are called autoantibodies. These antibodies may opsonize cells, and recruiting macrophage, activate complement systems that recruit neutrophils, or activate a different complement system that creates a membrane attack complex that induces lysis of cells. The examples of type 2 hypersensitivity are 1. Acute rheumatic fever, when the antibody for streptococcal cell wall antigens reacts with the myocardial antigen. 2. Good pasture syndrome, when the antibody reacts with type 4 collagen in the basement membrane of glomeruli of kidneys and alveoli. 3. Graves' disease, when the antibody reacts with TSH receptors. 4. Autoimmune hemolytic anemia, when the antibody reacts with the membrane's protein in the red blood cells. Type 3, or immune complex hypersensitivity. In this type, our antibodies may bind with an antigen, or another antibody, to make an immune complex. These immune complexes will be deposited in tissues and cause damage by activating the complement system. These diseases tend to be systemic. The examples of the diseases are 1. Systemic lupus erythematosus. 2. Post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. 3. Arthur's reactions. 4. Serum sickness. Type 4, or delayed cell-mediated hypersensitivity. It manifests within 48 to 72 hours, or is delayed. These type 4 hypersensitivity reactions are elicited by CD4+, Th1 cells, and CD8+ cells. CD4+ Th1 cells will secrete cytokines that activate macrophages and induce inflammation. Meanwhile, CD8+ cells will produce perforins and granzymes that induce apoptic cell death. Type 4 hypersensitivity is the exaggerated reactions of normal psychological events that help fight infections. Examples of type 4 hypersensitivity are 1. Mantoux tuberculin skin test for tuberculosis. 2. Contact dermatitis, elicited by nickel or poison ivy. 3. Hashimoto's thyroiditis. 4. Type 1 diabetes. 5. Multiple sclerosis. Again, in all hypersensitivity reactions, the first exposure to antigen sensitizes the lymphocyte, and the second exposure elicits a damaging reaction.